Okay, so how does the performance mean?
Actually, it's a bit nervous, but I try my best not to be nervous.
Okay, great one, great one.
Yeah, some applause for him.
Yeah, so let's take it easy and have some fun. And no need to go up all fancy, it will be juice for all. No need to worry about slick back hair with pomade, yeah? Your shiny hair will be just on. Yeah? Okay, so Miss Wisdom, can you start now? Okay, so without further ado, please welcome Mia from Nepal!
Okay, hello, good morning everyone!
Good morning!
As you know, my name is Anitha Sutra, I'm from Nepal, and today I'm going to share my comedy life story. First of all, have you ever wondered how magic enters the world? Does anybody know? No? No one? Actually, me as well. I don't know. Okay. But for the world, as you can see, I will show you magic first at the opening here. Biar gak pada ngantuk banget ya. Okay. So, first I will pick one of the judges, pick a card. Yeah, judges. Okay, please stop.
Okay, stop.
Okay. Show it to everyone, let's see.
Okay.
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 Yeah. You want some card? Okay. Okay. Now, as you can see, it's all down, but there's one card facing up. But it's not your card, right?
Right, no.
Because it's the position of your card. Look out. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5.
Yeah.
How do I do that? Learning. Dedication. Parents used to believe that scores is everything, right? Yeah, even when you get 95, like, Haiya, kenapa gak senang, terus senang banget. My childhood was like remarkable, some amazing, somehow sad. When we were child, we used to believe that growing up is amazing, fun, right? But actually not, it's like, how do you grow up? There's work, job, many things, you know, biology, A-level, physics, many more. Yeah! Okay, and now, when we grow up, we just want to go back to our childhood, then those memories. Yeah, tapi gak childish juga ya. I mean, can you imagine kalau ada bapak-bapak udah brewokan, matematik, I need more bullets! Yeah. Also, for your information, when I was in primary, I was really a close person. I'm really introverted. Can you imagine, like, there's this one time when I was in primary, well, I would rather cry instead of saying goodbye. Do you believe? So, like, when my friend, like, bye, and I was like, for real, you can ask my mom for that. It's okay, huh? Yeah, I was really deprived. I mean, like, how hard could it be? Tinggal angkat tangan, wave your hand, and ngomong aja. Yeah, that's easy. But actually, the best thing that have I ever seen in primary is when we try to answer the correct answer in front of the class. Yeah. Because every time, like, deal, come to front. Okay. I walk. And then when I'm in front of the whiteboard, I look back. I was hoping that one of my friends, like, tell me the answers. So, like, I was like, it's 2 times 3. Okay. And the teacher on the side was waiting, like, come on. I look to the back. And really, there's one friend I remember, like, 6. And I wrote down 6, I moved backwards, And the teacher was like inspecting the exer. Like, oh, tumben nih ternyata. Okay, correct. And then the class goes wild. Yeah, people like, woo! Everyone, yeah, that's right. Yeah, actually, like, at the moment, I was feel like genius. But for information, actually, why am I being genius? The last night, the night before that, I was taught by a Hogwarts sorcerer. The Hogwarts, Harry Potter. Yeah, I painfully learned from that, you know, because every time I study, there is always this flying broom going up to me. Even sometimes flying slippers. It's so sad. Stop. Okay, I think it's my time to go. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much. Yeah, wow, flying things. What kind of magic? Yeah. I do still remember the time when our teacher asked us to come in front and then asked us to like answer the questions. Yeah. And then I also remember what during exams. Like some of my friends were like asking me for the answers. You know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mending terus kalau misalnya dipanggil kayak pede aja dulu maju.
Iya. Kalau
panggil udah nanti aja.
Bener. Biasanya juga kita punya komunikasi mulai kayak misalnya kalau misalnya multiple choice gini. Tapi waktu itu the teacher already know it. So we find another way.
Okay.
So we find like the number of batu. Jadi kalau misalnya jawaban B berarti.
Oh, I see. Oh, that's
right. Yeah. We wanna tell the students that they be careful us because we were worse than them. Okay, so maybe kita dengar dulu dari judges yang mungkin silakan, Miss Master.
Artan,
yeah.
It was William Zelenskyy, but please watch out your microphone. Yeah, this is the network community, so the property of microphone. Because you did a lot of that art, you must take off the mic and then
because, like,
way to hold it.
Sometimes if I use the mic, the echo will rusak
suaranya. No, there is no echo. This is good sound system, right?
Oh, sound system.
This is good sound system. There is no echo. Yeah. That's what I know. And then you have a good self confidence. I appreciate that. Thank you.
So,
yes.
Okay. So, what happened in that stage? It's what you get when you have 100% of confidence. Give a applause. There are several flows in your stand-up, technically speaking. For example, in the first 1 minute of your stand-up, I don't know. It seems like you brought me to the wrong competition. I thought it was a master or something. I thought I'm a debutant or something.
Jadi debutant.
Overall, it was entertaining. Tapi tadi saya sepakat, I agree with Mister. Kalau mic itu penting ya. Tadi ada beberapa yang nggak terlalu terdengar atau kayak gimana. Kalau bisa, mungkin pegang aja deh. Itu biar memastikan kalau suara itu bisa terdengar. Terus apa lagi ya? Eh dia, tadi kan dia stand up pakai dua bahasa, saya juga dua bahasa ya. Oke, terus pembawaan bahasa kamu itu perhaps it's too, you know, terlalu baku. Agak terlalu baku menggunakan you're using a passive language instead of active language. So instead of engaging to us, we are forced to be engaged to your story, and if your story is not compelling enough, it will be a fail.
Yeah.
But I appreciate the bombs, like For those who don't know, bombset is something you throw when in case that your jokes didn't work. Ada beberapa jokes yang didn't work dan gue suka banget bombset itu kayak gini. Dan lu terusin karena itu menunjukkan kalau lu tuh udah paham situasi. Karena komedian tuh a good comedian is a comedian that knows the situation and his environment. Because if you don't know your surroundings, you will be a meh comedian. I think that's all for me.
Hi BL. Hello. Grade 11, right?
Yes.
I do believe that you get better already, right? It's proven that when your mom here, you don't feel like crying like the first day of your school.
I think I'm good.
Okay. Okay, basically I can enjoy your performance and I do really like you, your way to engage the audience, yeah? So it is proven that you know the situation. It's good luck. For your for your next year, I hope you can improve it. Since I also saw you last year, right?
Yes.
Okay, so much improvement. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Where did you come from?
Huh?
Where did you come from?
In Depok, like where I stay.
Yes.
Depok in GDC.
Oh, yeah. So if you want to learn more about stand up. I will wait you at Wednesday.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. Okay. Yeah, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Applause for being here. Well. Thank you so much, judges, for the input. Yeah. Hopefully, we won't stop. For if you have like practices, you. They may come to the room, yeah? Okay, let's proceed to the next performer. It's also from Depok, I feel Depok, Bintang Muhammad Aska. So, yeah, I mean, the Depok sent two stand-up comedians, and it's proven that Depok really appreciates the talent of the team, yeah? So, I invite Bintang. Bintang, so how is everything? How is your preparation?
Well, I just stay chill, and that's it, mostly.
Okay. How often, like, when did you do this for the first time? When did you begin doing this stand-up comedy?
Well,
just now.
The last 2 weeks, actually.
Last 2 weeks, okay. Right, no problem. It's a preparation already. Okay, so ready? So if you're ready, then let's welcome Bintang Muhammad Aska from
Harvard. Okay, so good morning.
Good morning.
So as you guys might know, my name is Bintang. And I'll get too fast straight. First of all, I'm Japanese. And my mom is also Japanese. But like, the thing is, she never taught me any actual Japanese, so we end up speaking Bahasa in the household the entire time. Second of all, I move around quite a lot, and at one point, I was in Bandung, where I studied there for quite a few years. And now, it was... Actually, do you guys know how in our education system, we have this thing called Mulang? Wanamabal, yes? Okay? So, yes, I was studying for my Mulang exam, and then my mom decided to check up on me. And let's say it went a little bit something like this. Eh, Alan, studying Mulang, my son very smart. You know, your mom back then very good in mulut, you know. A plus plus plus. Pokoknya top. Let your mom teach you. Let teach you Jawa. Okay. I mean, thanks for the help, mom. But like, Well, I don't think this kind of mulut is the mulut that you... Excuses again. If you make excuses again, I put you in sawah. You sleep with genderuwo. You wanna live with genderuwo? So, okay. I was in my elementary years back then, so I naturally believed whatever my mom said. So I did not say anything further, and I studied Japanese with my mom for the next few days. And then came the actual day of the mulut exam. And as I was about to go to my school, my mom came up to me and went something like this. Already going to ujian already. You prepared already or not? You know, teaching you Jawa very hard. Ngakuni wong Jawa tapi ra iso wong Jawa. Gusti. So hard, you know. I mean, okay. Thanks for the help. Like, thanks a lot. But like, I've been trying to tell you this one thing that you refuse to listen for these past 2 days. I don't want to hear too many excuses you made. Excuses again. Has 2, 3. Hey, what are you? Joe, kan? Where do you live? Bandung. What people speak in Bandung? Oh iya, kita ada something ya? So, turns out, it took her quite a long time to realize that the mulut material in Bandung is not Javanese, but Bahasa Sunda. So, yes, I was like, ya Allah. Okay, so, I decided like, what can you do? So, I decided to walk to my school without any sort of preparation. And then, I was like, okay. So, I want to at least greet my examiner with Bahasa Sunda to make at least a good first impression. So, it went like this. Sampo, Gilujin, Enjing, Ustaz, like that. But then, the examiner said the most mind-boggling, the most shocking statement that made me reflect on what I did back then, and it was one single statement. Nihama, welcome to Chinese exam. Like, come do your Chinese exam now. And that's when I realized I should check on my schedule a little bit more carefully. And by the way, mom, if you're watching this, I did not mean any harm. Hi, mom. Thank you.
Okay, kita kan?
Yes.
Okay. Actually, your premise is kind of interesting. Because you want to talk about you came from a Japanese family, you still believe in Japanese values, and that's why your mom expect you to learn Japanese or some stuff. But this premise is not delved properly. Masih banyak yang bisa digali dari sekitar dulu hingga. Terus I think that your setup is too long for that kind of pipeline for the pipeline ternyata bahasa Sunda in Bandung. First of all, we already addressed that you already told that you live in Bandung, so expect that the mulut should be in Sunda. So I think that we are depending the pipeline should be bahasa Sunda. But your Chinese imitation is good. Actually, may I ask, do you like watching stand-up?
Sorry?
Do you like watching stand-up comedy?
No, I haven't watched any actual stand-up comedy shows in my entire life, so...
Okay, di TV aja deh. Yang pernah kamu tonton siapa? Inggris Indonesia.
And it's kind of to begin that I've watched.
Ya, yang mungkin mempengaruhi kamu untuk stand up.
Mempengaruhi
stand up kamu. Mbak mungkin kayak misalnya kita mau stand up lah, kamu gak riset.
I don't know that many stand-up comedians, but the only one I know is probably Uncle Roger.
Ah, I see. That's why. Your invitation is like Uncle Rogerish. Yes, not Chinese. Uncle Rogerish. Uncle Rogerish. Yes, I can see that you want to, you know, roast a culture, right?
Not so much roasting, but yes.
Yes. You like to make references about Japanese culture, Chinese culture, and somewhat. But what you need to understand in stand up is that make sure you want you put it in the, you know, if you are a new stand up, make sure you want to put it in suatu sentence yang baku kayak premise, setup, and then punchline. So it will make it easier for you to, you know, to deliver your stand up.
And what's more?
Oh yeah. Considering the fact that this is an English language stand up comedy, your stand up comedy is I think it's more like Indonesian structure stand up comedy.
Oh.
Because I don't know. I see more of Raditya Dika and Zawin in you, but less funny.
Maybe more of a distant relative who looks.
Yeah, but okay. Here's the thing. For stand-up comedians, in order to be funny, you don't need to be funny first. You don't have to try to be funny. What you need to have is a robust setup. As long as you have a robust setup, the punchline will come through by itself. So I think, considering the fact that your premise is already interesting, the only PR for you is to, you know, to polish your punchline. I think that's all.
Thank you.
Okay, adding what Mr. Raihan has already informed, I agree with what Mr. Raihan has already taught, that you need to more structurize your material, the thing that you want to bring to your startup today. But basically, I like the way you impersonate your mom. I hope it will not. It will not cause any problem, between you and your mom. I hope.
Hopefully so.
Okay, and then just be more confident. Yeah, thank you.
Okay, Bintang. Yeah, so from my perspective from the performance, you established two more setup and your punchline to finish. Yeah, so. Next time, maybe you can improve maybe you can also improve, by watching some reference from the YouTube TV program, especially for the Zendaya, if you want to really want to be a choice. I think it's all from me. Thank you.
Okay. Again, big round of applause for I really like your performance. I do like how you make parody of your mom. But then after this, please come to your mom. kiss her hands.
Yes.
Hug her. Otherwise, you're gonna sleep in the sawah again. Okay. Thank you so much, Binta. Okay. Right. I think. Bintang is like just delivered like stories that every of us, especially the boys, the boys' relationship with their moms. Okay, right. Thank you so much. And without further ado, we have the third performer. It's Sensen. Yeah, I go with Sensen. Please come forward to the stage. Please give him a round of applause. Okay. So Sam, I think you participated in the last year's championship, right? For the stand-up comedy, and you won it, right?
Yes.
Right. How does that change you?
I got the title of the funniest man in Highfield.
Right. And what's the benefit?
No, it's not benefit. It's actually pressure.
What pressure? Okay, I thought you're gonna have like discounts in Canton because you're the funniest guy in the husband. No, yeah?
You can take my 100,000 voucher.
Okay. Right, so enjoy the stage, yeah? So, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, please welcome Sensei!
Alright, so last week, I read a study that shows that Gen Z age faster than millennials, and the cause is stress, environmental pressure, and screen time. So, first is stress. We all got this stress, right? Relationship stress, academic stress, and environmental pressure like your parents asking you to be an academic achiever, you got to get A star, and if you get B, it means bad. That's so hard for me, actually. And the other thing is screen time. Most of you might be denial that I'm all that. Screen time won't make me age faster, but it does, guys. UV radiant does make you age faster. So I'm gonna tell you my top two experience of that Gen Z is aging faster than millennials, because I've experienced it myself. Alright, so the first thing is, I was in a lift, the one Cirebon don't have, Kota Bekasi have. Yeah, I was with my aunt is my mom's little sister. She's 10 years older than me. And then there's this uncle, this old uncle, that gets in the lift with me. He stares at me very, very hard. I was just playing my phone. I was just, playing my phone, watching TikTok, showing it to my auntie. I mean, we look like a couple. And then he suddenly say, "Oh wow, you guys are such a happy married couple." I was like, "No, I'm not." "Oh, then you must be his uncle, her uncle." And I'm like, that is the worst insult I've ever received in my entire life. I look like this, and I'm being told that my uncle's aunt. It's so hurtful. And the second experience is with my own dad. I was in a car show. I like cars. I was in a car show, and then me and my dad, we walk around. And then one of my dad's friend that I don't know, he don't know me also. And then he's like, "Oh, is this your brother?" Do I look that old to be called my dad's brother? It's like the worst insult to have. It's one of the most depressing things. And that's why it causes stress also. And I'm aging faster again right now. See, you can see the teachers here, they look so young, and we the students, we look so old. You can say that the millennials are transferring their stress to us, so we age faster than them. And also, my third experience is, there's this little kid, like this tall. He comes up to me and he said, "Uncle, I think you look older than my dad." I'm like, why are you gonna say that to me? That innocent little face, they mean one of the worst insults also in my life. It stuck with me for 3 years now. So please watch your words when you say something to someone, and if it's someone you don't know. So, I'm gonna give you one moral of the story. It's just watch your words to what you say, because it can cause something you don't know that it will cause him like stress, depression, or anything. Please watch your words. And I accept any insults right now if you say that I'm older than Mr. Ferry or what. I accept it because economy is pressuring me very bad. So, basically, enjoy your life, guys. Us Gen Z, we should enjoy our life so we don't age so fast. But I'm also worried about our next generation, the next generation after Gen Z. It will be my kid. I'm scared that my kid will be called my brother also. Like, I can feel his heart broken, you know. So yeah, I think that's all from me. I'm Vincent from Highfield Cherubon. Thank you guys.
First of all, I'm gonna say that I'm gonna ask you, do you enjoy your performance today? Be honest.
Yeah, I enjoy. I'm being honest.
Okay. Because I don't know. I feel like your jokes is kind of work. I think your jokes I think will work better if you deliver it in Indonesian. I don't know. I get the sense of that because there are several points in your performance where you want to find an exact word to deliver your material, right?
Yes.
Okay. I don't know if this is the right thing to do, but gue pengen denger lu materi pakai bahasa Indonesia dong. Gak apa-apa. Gak satu dua menit aja, gak apa-apa.
Oke, tentang materi yang tadi aja.
Terserah.
Jadi pertama tuh kalau di Indonesia, mungkin gini ceritanya. Saya pas itu dari hotel, ada di Matthew Central Park, kalau kalian tahu. Itu saya masuk lift, dan saya bersama I saya, itu adiknya mam saya. Terus tiba-tiba ada om-om masuk. Ada om-om masuk dengan mukanya yang sedikit tua. Saya gak berani bilang lebih tua karena saya kena asamnya sedikit. Saya lagi main HP doang begini. Saya lagi main HP. Saya cuma main HP, gitu. Saya kasih tahu video yang lucu ke I saya. Tiba-tiba saya dikatain saya suami istri sama I saya. Lu gak sakit hati kalau dikatain kayak gitu loh. Apa harus saya tunjukin KTP anak saya ke depan kau gitu? Mungkin harus begitu lah ya.
Oke.
Do you know the difference?
Rasa nggak deh?
Rasa.
Jadi gini. In every language there is a nuance in every words. And every words in English and Indonesia have its own different nuances. So when you say tadi apa yang bahasa Cina tadi cici apa i sama om itu ada diksi yang lucu yang bisa lu hanya bisa lu bawa ketika lu di Indonesia. Tapi ketika di Inggris itu agak susah. Jadi I think your problem is that you translate your material. From Indonesia to English, truly. That's why I think pembawaan lu di bahasa Indonesia itu lebih lepas. Kenapa? Karena lu di Inggris itu susah nyari wordsnya gitu loh. Tadi akhir-akhir itu lu lucu. Karena strukturnya juga masih bisa di the structure itself is not a problem. Your structure is good. Your structure is a stand up structure. Yes. But the nuances that you bring to us is different, and I can see that from here. And second, your opening is too long. Actually, you can I don't know. You guys in here are trying to to have a long story for opening. That's not a strategic one. You need to have. One or two bits, two funny bits to start your performance, and then you move to your story. you forward to your story, and I think it will inform you. It will increase your performance better. And what else? I think you are too detached from your material. I don't know. Is it really something that you feel? Is it really something that you feel? Because it's too structured. Too structured is not good because you are not exploring yourself freely. Jadi untuk awal-awal stand up ya, kalau menurut gua bahasnya deket-deket banget sama lu, biar gampang banget bahasnya. Itu sih yang menurut gua kurang dari lu. Karena lu langsung, gua nggak tahu. I think you're pushing hard to bring social phenomena. I don't know. Perhaps you are not really, convinced with your material. I think that's the problem. Thank you.
Hi, Sensei.
Yes.
A bit nervous?
Yes. I'm actually very nervous.
Okay. I can saw it from your shaking.
Yeah, that's my problem. I shake when I'm nervous. I'm not shake like this, but
Yeah.
You can ask my teachers when I put on MC for the events. It's cool. I'm like.
But I do really appreciate you can make use of your 5 minutes and you can finish it in a very smooth way. Keep going, Susan. Okay. Wait, I need to watch my word. Yeah? Like what you said before. Okay. So actually I like your setup, your first promise. It's based on your research. I appreciate that. And actually your premises is quite structured, but yes, like what Mr. Raihan has already told you, that you can actually explore more about the premise that you actually get it from your research or maybe your observation towards social phenomena. That will be better if you can explore it more. Yeah, keep improving, Sensei. Thank you.
Emotion lu tuh yang agak kurang di sini. Kayak kurang ada rasa gitu loh, kayak. Kita tuh harus percaya tuh kesel banget kalau lu dianggap tua. Bener-bener emotion lu kayak tadi tuh mau nyari apa ya? Ya emotion lu, makanya biasanya kalau lu nyari yang dekat, lu yang nyari dekat, emosinya akan terasa kayak si Bial tadi. Kayak si Bial tadi tuh emosinya terasa. Dia walaupun strukturnya emang agak dipertanyakan, tapi dia bisa membawakan itu. Kenapa? Karena dia tuh udah 100% pede aja, udah kayak dia mau sulap, mau itu, kayak dia juga gak peduli dinilai sama gue, gak peduli dia. Itu yang menurut gue kurang dari dulu. Harus bisa ngeliat panggung ini itu sebagai tempat lo untuk mengeksplorasi, bukan sebagai tempat lo untuk menang. Karena menang itu bagi gue cuma bonus. Percuma lo mau pengen menang pakai yang dianggap lucu kalau seandainya, kalau itu membuat lo gak enjoy. Itu sih, kalau dari gue.
Okay. I saw you very nervous, yes. I know you're shaking. Anyway, that will ruin your performance. Yeah, being honest, yeah, it's okay, yeah. Maybe you can improve the next time. And so far for what I got from you, you can still improve with a good self-confidence, also good, even though you do speaking like this, when you hold in your microphone. And it's okay, then you can control yourself, and then you also just in time. I appreciate that. Good luck, yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, please, everyone, give a big round of applause for Sensei again. I really like your performance. I mean, I know how it feels. But then, in my case, I was mostly seen to be younger than my age, which is also nggak bagus juga. Gitu. Nah, jadi mau beli barang-barang yang harusnya udah bisa dibeli untuk dewasa, juga nggak bisa. But then. Ya gitulah ya, oke. But then ya, just enjoy. Okay, thank you so much. Okay. Okay. Now, last but not least, we'll have the next performer, Ivan from IVA Durian Sawi. Come on, Ivan. How was the preparation, Ivan?
How long
was it?
Okay. Right.
So I think because we're out of time, so without further ado, please welcome Ivan from Highfield Turun Sawi.
Jadi perkenalkan, nama gue Ivan dan gue mau izin pakai bahasa Indonesia terus pakai bahasa yang gue dulu. Jadi sebagai awal kata, gue pengen berterima kasih karena udah hadir di sini. Dan ya udah 15 detik gue gak mau lama-lamain karena gue gak mau kayak peserta sebelumnya 1 menit cuma buat main sulap doang, padahal jelas-jelas di depan namanya stand up comedy. 1 menit main sulap itu sesamanya kayak Jokowi udah 5 periode. Nah, jadi ya sebelum gue mulai juga, gue juga pengen kita semua di sini bertepuk tangan karena kita ada hadiah dari gua untuk air kalau menang 2-1. Gua dengar dari teman gua di sekolah gua menang debat 2-1 dapat voucher 50.000, admission fee 70.000. Gua masuk registrasi dapat voucher 100.000 malah. Jadi sekarang gua tanya, lu mau bayar 70.000 stand up comedy menang 50.000 padahal winning saja sponsor lebih banyak dapat duit. Jadi gua lebih mending ikut belajar di winning saja kemarin di IVA gak sih? Ayo ketemu lagi. Oh iya, gua juga ada nih. Kalian kan pasti semua di sini lihat ada bazar kan di bawah. Bazar di bawah tuh gua tau pas kemarin. Gua tuh udah 10 tahun di IVA makan di bawah di kantin 20.000 dapat nasi sama ayam. Gue jamin di bawah Batagor paling 20.000 dapat 3 doang. Akhirnya dapat 3 doang, 20.000 tuh dapat Batagor 8, Batagor Wagyu. Batagor Wagyu pun gue jamin siap kena gak bakal makan juga gara-gara bekas Highfield juga. Dan kalian tahu kan, modal mahal, SPT mahal, Cirebon aja cuma punya gak ada lift malahan kan ya. Sedangkan di sini ada lift, Durian Sawit ada lift. Terus gimana? Terus sama lagi. Nah di sini gue tuh roasting seluruh teman dibayar teman kalau nggak pernah kan ya lucu. Nah lupa bilang makanan mahal di sekolah tuh jujur gak kaget juga sih, SPP aja 5 juta, 5 juta dapat fasilitas. Sekolah di Cirebon gak ada yang namanya lift, di sini sekolah gede muridnya dikit, makanan udah mahal. Gue aja sampai bingung, gue kemarin mau makan siang apa beli makan McD. McD udah diboikot, tapi makanan lagi murah di makanan di bawah. Beda paling cuma 10.000 doang dapat nasi ayam telur, bawah cuma dapat nasi sama ayam doang terus makan saus doang. Jadi buat apaan gue ikut gitu mana? Mending gue pindah ke SDN negeri dapat Batagor 5 dengan harga 10.000. Terus gue nggak tahu kalau sekolah lain ya. Nah terus dan ya, kalau untuk cerita tentang sekolah itu sekolah itu yang paling menarik karena Durian Sawit sendiri itu memang rumornya tuh paling banyak yang punya murid itu yang gue dengar dan memang kelihatan banyak juga. Dan kalau dilihat-lihat prinsipalnya tuh memang kan bukan prinsipal deh yang megang duitnya tuh maruk. Udah dengar kan yang megang duit maruk pada demi sekolah. Gue bayar 5 juta pun itu solusi fasilitasnya jelek banget. Gua pernah dengar dari teman-teman gua punya AC setahun panas-panasan udah dibilang ke OB, udah dibilang ke misalnya ke prinsipalnya langsung itu tuh AC nggak pernah diperbaiki. Itu school life kenangan SMA dari mana itu coba gua tanya. Gua jaminin aja deh kalau kita mau jalan-jalan ke SDN manapun, gue jamin fasilitas dibanding dengan harga masih lebih mending. Dan sorry to say ya, kalau dilihat-lihat juga, gue lihat tadi di buku panduan, kalau gue harus menyampaikan materi dalam bahasa Inggris. Gue 10 tahun belajar bahasa Inggris, gak bisa juga bahasa Inggris, jadi pada akhirnya ya. Mr. Arsi, guru Inggris saya, 10 tahun.
Jadi
berpikir. 10 tahun tapi Mister belajar bahasa Inggris enggak bisa pakai bahasa Inggris bahasa Indonesia. Mungkin ya udah 4 menit 30 detik gua tahu gua enggak lucu gara-gara tadi tadi ketawa. Terus dia kena ketawa sama sensor. Oh, sama kita aja lebih banyak orang pada bisa enggak ketawa juga. Mungkin itu aja sih. Gua jujur di sini memang dipaksa itu yang pertama dan yang kedua tuh memang buat roasting. Dan gue jamin kalau gue lanjut roasting ini namanya bukan roasting lagi sih, tapi Hiroshima sih. Terima kasih.
Oke, Daniel, Daniel atau Ivan dipanggilnya?
Bebas.
Bebas, oke okay, bebas. Ya cocok-cocok kayak gitu aja kan ya. Ya simpel-simpel. Gini. Mungkin pertama orang kaget kali ya. Perhaps people shocked that you are not doing your stand up in Indonesia and you never bother to you know explain it why you do stand up in Indonesia. Kenapa harusnya misalnya you can say that this is Indonesia, no USA. Lu bisa kayak gitu, lu bisa apa sih namanya kasih konteks apa itu dan kayak menurut gua ini bukan roasting yang lebih ke protes sih. Iya, lebih protes ke ini ke sekolah. Jadi roasting itu selain harus ada persetujuan kedua belah pihak kalau ada kalau mereka akan di roasting ya. Roasting itu enggak cuma ngejelek-jelekin tapi juga nge-point out logical flaws dari orang yang sedang di roasting. Atau kayak ada inkonsistensi atau apa dari yang itu kalau lu tadi itu apa ya? Wajis gimana ya? Kayak apa ya? Kayak demo. Kayak deh, kalau tinggal kurang bakar ban aja di sini, kurang bakar ban aja tuh, apalagi ya, pronunciation lu sih, pronunciation lu maksud gua, ini even in Indonesia, jadi kalau stand up itu harus ada penekanan-penekanannya, jadi kalau tadi itu lu kayak terus aja kayak terus aja, lu nggak ada titik di mana lu tuh penekanan ini lo ada ini lo, kayak misalnya tadi sakit ini tuh gua bingung tadi lu mau apa di sini. kayak gimana ya kayak gue udah dengerin orang protes cuman yang diprotes juga nggak ngerti apa yang perlu diprotes ya nggak sih apa cuman gue yang ngerasa itu gue juga nggak tahu sih apa ya lu tuh satu yang masih mungkin bisa gue props adalah ketika lu sadar lu nggak lucu lu notice cuman saya gue notice telat pas baru mau 5 menit padahal lu tuh udah gak lucu dari menit pertama sih. Lu notice dia gak lucu ya. Itu cuma satu itu aja dan gimana ya lain kali next time mungkin lu kasih konteks di stand up lu karena stand up yang bagus itu bukan yang pancanya wadaw yang pancanya bener-bener buah kocak kagak. Yang stand up yang bagus itu adalah stand up yang premisnya kuat. Kenapa lu ngomongin ini? Kenapa lu ngomongin ini? Dan penonton tuh harus tahu harus bisa percaya sama lu. Bisa percaya kalau lu ngomongin ini, lu bakal lucu. Ini permasalahan penonton kayaknya gak percaya. Iya, jadi gini, stand up itu adalah seni untuk menyakinkan audiens. Kalau kita ini sedang lucu loh, sedang berpendapat dan pendapat kita lucu. Itu yang kurang dari lu. Jadi lu apa ya? Kayak gak usah dari ini deh, gue ngeliat gak usah dari kata-kata lu, tapi dari bagaimana cara lu berdiri, cara lu apa sih jalan, cara lu ini, lu tuh kayak udah gak yakin duluan. Jadi coba tadi siapa yang pertama tadi Biel itu mungkin secara struktur stand up agak aneh, cuman kenapa dia bisa mengundang tawa? Karena dia pede tuh, dia pede dengan materi dia, apapun yang keluar itu lucu. Dan terbukti dia lucu walaupun dia awal-awal agak membuang waktu cuman dia yakin sama dia itu yang kurang dari dulu tuh harus yakin kalau stand up itu sih dari gua terima kasih.
Okay Daniel, you already realize now because the rules must be delivered in English but you admit it, it's good yeah and you have a good performance delivering material in Bahasa Indonesia. I like it. Thank you.
Hey, Ivan. Actually, for me, I like your observation. You can use what is currently happened. You can what does that show you? Good observation of what happened before to your competitor, and also you know that Mr. RC is here, so that you can relate it to English. Maybe that's a good observation, actually. So you can make use of your good observation to make more structurized premises probably, yeah. Apart from that, I like you can make use of the time well here. Keep improving. Thank you.
One more. Mungkin yang apa tuh yang butuh lo tambahin itu selain kepercayaan diri apa? Pronunciation dulu ya biar lebih jelas dan juga ini relatability. Jadi saran gue ya setiap lu mau ngejokes, lu jangan nonton kayak lu relate gak sih supaya lu tahu lu bisa ngebahasnya apa enggak. Kalau misalnya penonton gak relate, penonton harus usah ketawa. Kalau penonton gak relate, udah lu cari materi lain yang penonton relate biar penonton tuh tahu apa yang lu bahas, karena ketawa itu lahir dari relatability. Itu sih, terima kasih.
Ivan, you're giving a hard bad day today. But thank you for so much, Ivan. Okay, yeah. Everyone learns today. Okay, thank you so much, And before we end this session, the competition, I would like to have a final remarks probably from like one of the judges to have like final remarks. Get your mic.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Asi. Okay, probably it's just a short. First of all, give applause to all the participants here. So, from me, I would like to say thank you very much. In the middle of your preparation of your CT, A-level preparation probably, you try to spend your time to prepare the material. And yeah, I hope you can make use of the things that the judges get input today, give you the input today, and you can make use of that to improve your skill in reading the stand-up comedy probably.
Okay, in case those of you want to do stand up or want to, you know, take stand up more seriously, I can give you a place for you to, you know, polish your skills. In Depok, there is Stand Up Indo Depok. You can come at that day at Coffee Toffee Depok if you want to watch the stand ups or to try your materials. In Cirebon, there is also Stand Up Indo Cirebon, and during summit there is Stand Up Indo Jakarta Timur. And you can, you know, if you want to, you know, polish your skill there, we are very welcome for your assistance. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much, judges, for the closing remarks. So yeah, I think everyone's curious on who wins. So the winners will be announced at 4 p.m. in hall, in hall on the ground floor. And for now, I, as your MC, want to express my gratitude to the participants, the judges, and the fantastic audience that added so much energy to today's event. So see you again at the Stand Up Comedy event next year. Have your championship, unlock your power. I'm Mr. RC, signing off. Thank you.